Why? Just go away. Just please stop existing. God damn it.
I don't want to read this anymore.
I want to like erase you from the existence. Like seriously.
Because that's straightforward bullying. I refuse. I cannot stand this. I cannot.
I feel such a rage in this role.
No. I don't want to get near
I'm
them.
Going to be so mad and angry at this. I'm sorry.
I said that many times, but I cannot.
I don't care. Her existence is hostility.
Hello and welcome, Pocket Watch here, and it's about time for yet another episode of Little Busters. Yeah, so last time we've spent amazing time with Haruka and not so amazing time with Utaki. So it went 50-50, it went amazing, it was horrible and amazing at the same time. It depends on which side and on with which character, but yeah, that was pretty intense. And I wonder what will happen next, because I'm curious, like, why Haruka's in the state? Like, what's the reasoning, like, for her, for being like this? And why Ricky don't remember her? Probably because they were, like, too young and stuff, but who knows? Anyway, let us continue the story, so remember to hit that like button if you like the episode, dislike if you dislike, and then you can also subscribe if you're still not subscribed, and let's go! And you can also join Discord, by the way, which is in the description. Haruka-san! After school! When I saw Haruka-san, I called out to her. Yeah, we are finally on the good road. I guess. When Haruka-san recognized my voice, she gave a small, startled jump. Usually it's you who's like appearing out of nowhere. You are the one who always runs into me. Exactly! She was talking nonsense straight off the bat, just as she always. Were you headed somewhere? Haruka-san had hammered at... had a hammer and pliers poking out of one of her pockets of her school uniform. What are you trying to do? The other pocket was bulging as well. Sure, I'm not busy. We're going to be troublemakers together. Let's do this! Let's go against Futaki, yes! Do what? Okay. Do the thing. Haruka? I have questions for you. Okay. And then sticky? Oh my god. I don't believe it, we're starting episode like that. Oh my god, Haruka, you're amazing, I love it. Oh my god. Haruka-san let out a relaxed sigh with a dreamy look on her face. Oh my god. She's better. Oh my god. She's better than Kurugaya in this. Oh my god, I swear she's better than Kurugaya. Oh my god. Haruka-san whispered the question. Still dreamy eyed. Sure. Why I know that? I felt my heart picking up the tempo for some reason. Yeah, because your subconsciousness tell you what she means. And that's actually not what you think. But maybe she thinks that, but maybe not. I don't know. Hey, Haruka-san. So, exactly... Where exactly is that and sticky stuff happening? Okay. Okay, got it. I pressed on the seat of the wooden bench. Haruka-san hammered on it from above. The cautious rapping of the hammer went. Okay. Right, got it. I burned some of the polywood back. This? Okay. Haruka-san pulled out a tube of glue, and then applied it on the joint of the bench. Haruka-san, are we doing the bench maintenance? I
guess.
That's your club activities.
Well, I mean, I get that, but...
Okay. Are you sure you should be napping instead of going to class? Haruka-san softly stroked the back of the bench. Okay. That's fine. Well, I'm the vice president of the maintenance committee. So if you ask me to help, of course I will. Yes. I don't mind now. I kind of minded that back then, but not now anymore. Haruka-san mumbled, smacking herself lightly on the forehead. That's how she forgot. I made a dumbfounded face as I started her with my hands on my waist. Oh my god, do we like really have like another person with like amnesia, like Komari, what the hell? She was just like joking around and she like forgot basically about the joke. Well, it was something meaningful to me at least. Haruka-san slipped the hammer and screwdriver back into her pocket. It looked like the job was finished. Something wrong? Oh, problem. It makes me happy. Fixing up stuff, not just for myself, but for everyone. When I said that, Haruka-san gave me a rather bamboozled smile. Right when Haruka-san opened her mouth to continue. Oh my god! Why? Just go away! Just please stop existing! God damn it! I don't want you in the story! She's so annoying! Literally, like... That's the most annoying person ever! I swear! There was a cold voice. Futaki-san. Why do I have to add the sound? I will just call her Futaki. Without like any honorifics. God damn it. I looked over my shoulder and there she was. Haruka-san was silent. What are you talking about? Haruka-san muttered. Haruka-san mumbled silently to herself. Haruka-san started to formulate a weak comeback, but Futaki-san cut her off. Under the furious scolding, Haruka-san hung her head in dejection. I noticed that her clenched fists were beginning to tremble. Haruka-san had snapped up as she cut Futaki-san off. Haruka-san yelled to drown out Futaki-san's voice. In her rejection of those words of reprimand, she shouted at the top of her lungs. Haruka-san made it as to kick the bench. Haruka-san! But she let her foot drop back to the ground. It looked like her self-control had got the upper hand before she could actually kick it. In her irritation, Haruka-san began stomping her foot on the ground. The screwdriver slipped out of her pocket. In her blind rage, Haruka-san jolted it away.
Haruka-san quit it. Stop it, Haruka-san. I cut Haruka-san's arm and held her back as she tried to grab for Futaki-san. Asamo managed to drag Haruka-san, who had been planting her feet firmly on the ground away from the bench. Futaki-san, I addressed her while I tried to turn Haruka-san away. Is it really necessary to preach at Haruka-san like this for the things she does? What's your fucking problem? Like, she wanted to repair it, she did. She knew that it would be replaced. Like, who cares? She repaired it anyway. Like, what's your fucking point? Just leave it be. You want to replace it, then replace it. Like, who the fuck cares? God damn it. I'm sorry, I'm just like so agitated to... But even so, you still don't have to talk to her this way. As I began to defend Haruka-san, an insinuating tone crept into Futaki-san's voice.
にだいぶさせるのね、あなたは自分がしてることを邪魔する人間が悪いと自分は感情的に暴れて他人に主張させるの。自分の口で言いなさい。そんなことも言えないのよね。あなたはいつでもそう。他人の迷惑なんてどうでもいいのよね。他人を厄介ごとに巻き込んで。どうしようっていうの。最低ね。最低。
What's your problem? Haruka-san was gnawing her lip. Haruka-san. Futaki-san had pulled out her cell phone and was making calls somewhere. After a short while, a group of prefects showed up. You're a fucking piece of shit. You are garbage. This is garbage. I don't want to read this anymore. I literally don't want to continue. You are fuck, I swear. After a flat refusal, Futaki-san issued her order to the prefects. Haruka-san reached out her hand, but the orders were executed efficiently. The prefects promptly began to trash the small wooden bench. Haruka-san gasped. At least Haruka-san averted her gaze from the scene. After a few moments of a horrible noise, the bench was split in two. It all happened so quickly. In an instant, what had been the bench had been reduced to mere scrap. The prefects dumped what was left of the bench into the wheelbarrow. What have you? How could you do this right in front of her? You are fucking trash. I hate you so much. Oh my god. You beat every character I didn't like in this novel. I didn't like Sasami because how bossy she was and her minions kicked cats. But this is whole other level. This is piece of garbage. Futaki-san words, I felt my rage rising. My hand calling it a fist, I took a step towards her. A sudden pressure stopped me. Haruka-san? Haruka-san had both of her arms wrapped around me. But she didn't have to do this. Not like this, she didn't. I tried to tear away from Haruka-san. When I heard Haruka-san yelling, I pulled myself together. What
What is? What was right? I glared at Futaki-san. Futaki-san merely stood there indefinitely observing us. That was how she saw it. You fucking piece of shit, like, go away, just, I want to like erase you from the existence, like seriously. With that is Mrs. Fly and she let Haruka-san and me to ourselves. I hate this
so much, I like my stress level is insane right now.
How is it possible that you you love this road so much? I guess, like, Haruka is amazing, and probably her road is amazing because maybe because of Futaki, because Futaki is such a garbage. I don't know, maybe.
God fucking damn it.
Haruka-san was still holding me. You can let go now. It's over. Clutching into me, Haruka-san shook her head a little. No matter what I said, Haruka-san just kept repeating that. It's fine. Though it certainly wasn't fine. Anger was still simmering inside of me. I swear, if I would be like in the school, like, in going to like, without like actually like hitting Futaki and stuff, right? How can we like repay her? I think we can just go straight to the teacher and just tell him like, how she's like basically bullying one of the students, because that's straightforward bullying. This is straightforward making other student crying and feel painful way, destroying stuff that they like, and they just repair that. Teacher would not be like, yeah, that was like meaningless, she deserved that. That would be not the case. So seriously, I would do everything for Futaki to just lose her position as the, like, president of, like, this, like, committee and just, like... Just... What the garbage, god damn it. I feel like I need a break. I just started. Anger was still simmering inside of me. No shit. However, that wasn't the only reason I sounded so ill at ease. If Haruka-san hadn't stopped me, detention, suspension, those words came to my mind unwaited. Yeah, you can just like report this, like what she did, and this might be her nightmare then. I was sure that Futaki-san was hoping that everyone who got close to Haruka-san would end up like that. Even though my opponent was a girl. If I really had hit her, I would have gotten much more than just self-loathing afterward. Letting the blood rise to my head, what had I been thinking? Haruka-san gave me a dry smile. Haruka-san, why? Why do we have to obey her? Are we just supposed to ignore what she said and done to you? Yeah, exactly. Like, we have to fight this. Like, there's like... I refuse to obey her. You are not in the wrong here. That's something like that. The sound of hammers beating away at the bench came back to me. It had been a horrible sound. That and the wailing of the breaking wood. It had felt like, besides just the bench, something precious was being destroyed before my very eyes. Haruka-san muttered.
Yeah, like I said, she knew, but she wanted to repair it anyway because it holds probably a lot of memories for her. If it would be like replaced anyway, you cannot change that. It was already ordered, like from higher ups, from teachers probably and stuff. But she still wanted to do like one last job, like renovation for this bench. It doesn't matter. It was important for her. Like, why would you care that someone wanted to like repair it? You could like just switch it, like, if it's fine bench, you can just like place it in some other place. Not like destroy it and just throw away if it was just repaired.
You said that earlier too. What, your that you have memories of it? Ruka-san quickly bowed her head down deeply. You don't have to apologize. Ruka-san raised her head, showing a forced smile. She recovered too fast. That's Haruka, huh? Even though she said that, I could tell she was bluffing, yep. This is painful. This is literally painful to watch when she just like play like this. Just like, yeah, I'm happy now, that's fine. And we know that's not okay. Because Haruka-san, isn't your left hand trembling? Even though you are putting on such a brave face. Rushing out that closing line, Haruka left at a run. I couldn't say anything at all to her. You don't have to pretend. Should I have told her that? All I could think was that Haruka-san thoughts and mine, on some fundamental level, were not meeting. Wow, I feel like that could be the end of the episode, like that was so packed with the emotions, holy crap. But we are only like 25 minutes in. Oh. Only 25 minutes and so much happened. The sound of bench being destroyed kept resounding in my ears to the point I couldn't sleep last night. I wish they stood up against Futaki at some point. Better sooner than later. I cannot stand this. They don't have to go that far. They didn't have to go that far. I wonder why disciplinary committee member or Futaki-san is so harsh toward Haruka-san. Yeah, exactly. The day started with that running through my mind. In the middle of switching classrooms, I remembered that I had left my textbook behind. So I went back to the previous room for it. It's not something I often do, leaving something behind in the class, but it's an honest mistake that could happen to anyone. The back door of the classroom rattled as I opened it. Textbook, eh? The classroom was empty. Well, at least it was supposed to be. Haruka-san was there, looking at the blackboard. What's she doing? Was she planning to write Haruka was here with the chalk again? If so, I should stop her. Haruka-san... As I was calling to her, Haruka-san turned her head and saw me. Her face was ghastly pale. What's happening? Oh my god, I'm scared. I expect this road to be related to depression. As I said before, this is like so fucking horrible. Please don't do anything stupid. Her lips moved. Can't be. Her lips soundlessly seemed to form those words. All of a sudden, she began to furiously move the blackboard eraser in her left hand. Haruka-san? I approached the teacher desk. someone wrote something on the blackboard? They bullying her now. This is so... I should have like some kind of like stress ball around, like, I swear.
So she had been planning to do some graffiti after all. Nope.
I smiled really.
You can't do that, Haruka-san. The prefect will be after you again.
Haruka-san left sleeve was pure white with chalk dust. Yep, she was like trying to get rid of whatever what that there was.
She must have been drawing something quite sizzable on the board. What was I supposed to do with her?
You really don't learn, do you, Haruka-san? After Masato yelled at you like that before.
Haruka-san made a show of holding her head.
Suddenly Haruka-san body stiffened. Futaki-san. The door had flung open.
I hate you so much. Go away, leave us alone. Just leave the school. Just seriously. I'm sorry about this episode. I'm so antagonistic against Futaki, but I just cannot like. I cannot. Let me know in the comment if you have the same feeling.
From out the corridor, Futaki-san was staring at us with an unreadable expression.
And what do you care? Like, we are in the classroom talking. Go away.
Doing? I'm just here to grab a textbook, I forgot.
You fucking... I swear, you are such a piece of shit.
Futaki-san suddenly yelling. Wait a second, Futaki-san. Behind the front of aggressive questioning, somehow I caught just a hint of panic or confusion. Like I said, I forgot one of my books. As I answered, slightly bewildered by how Futaki-san was acting, I was interrupted by Haruka-san. Eh? Her flat voice startled me.
Yes, go with it!
Yeah. Futaki-san was silent. Haruka-san was staring at Futaki-san, her eyes ablaze. They were almost glowing with what? Rage, probably. The closest I could come to describe it was a deep, dark, and raw emotion. It was hatred. The air between them cracked with tension. The first one to look away was Haruka. She jerked her gaze away abruptly and left the classroom without another word. After I watched Haruka-san, Futaki-san called to me over the shoulder.
I don't want to speak with you!
What are you talking about? If that's about the graffiti, Haruka-san didn't do it. Would you just stop blaming her for every small thing that happens? It's no wonder she's always angry at you when you have such a witch hunt going on for her. Futaki-san let out a small breath. Apparently having assured herself of something, Futaki-san issued me one of her standard warnings. I shouldn't get involved with you, I don't want to hear you anymore, just go away. When she put it that way, even I had to agree. That's why I told her to stop, so it wouldn't cause a scene. Last time it was a pain erasing the graffiti. I shouldn't be involved with you, fuck you. That again, I don't really tell you, I have no intention of listening to you. Yeah, I'm desperate to not be involved with you. After all this, what are you saying now? Don't get the wrong idea. Haruka-san is a joker, then the troublemaker. But that's not all she ever is. I know that for a fact. Ah, now that you mention it. Futaki-san took off walking without another word. Futaki-san, this conversation isn't over. Fuck you, same to you! There will be no yellow cards for you. Takesan didn't even look over her shoulder as she said it. And then she was gone.
You didn't even give me any fucking yellow card. You're like just talking bullshit around. I hate this. I feel such a rage in this road.
I plainly understood that, as the prefect Futaki-san considered Haruka-san her enemy. I guess they didn't want her rebellious pranks to infect the surrounding students. So it's not like I couldn't see her side of it. I can't! This is literally just bullying and...
She had taken it upon herself to fill this role. And she must have known, she would be discriminated, hated, and shunned by many of it. But still, something was strange about Haruka-san's circumstances as well. Haruka-san had to have a reason to hate Futaki-san that much. If I assume that, there got to be something wrong, something going on with Futaki-san. I fought back. Recalling the dangerous atmosphere from mere moments earlier, I let out a sigh.
There were students doing work in the dorm head's room again today. I had come to ask the head of the boys' dorm for some replacement furniture. Thanks for your help. The girls' dorm head, who was busy tidying up some documents on her desk, called me as I started to leave. Yeah, what is it?
No! I don't want to get near them! I swear to God, please don't!
Is the committee meeting room right around the corner? Toss it in. If I did it like that, wouldn't they get angry? The doormat stretched her arms. My shoulders hurt, she muttered, patting her shoulder. Almost like a granny. The head prefect is sort of... Well, with the whole business between her and Haruka-san, I just didn't have very good impression of her. No shit, Sherlock. And she's a piece of garbage! You forgot that! You think so? You have just told her to call me senpai, she sighed to herself. Haruka-san did? Why this is the choice? Why I'm scared of this? Oh my god, I'm so scared of this. I'm so scared of this choice. Should we go and meet see what's happening with Haruka? Or should we just leave it be? I think we should go and support Haruka. I will go. I hate Futaki, but I will go. I need to support her. I need to support Haruka. Actually, maybe that's a mistake. Because it will be again probably that we are trying to protect Haruka and she's like not protecting herself. But once again, we want to do that. This is because of our own like interest, not because she asked us for doing that. Well then, excuse me. I left the dorm head's room. I was feeling tense already, but I figured it would be fine if I just dropped off the report. Still, I was interested in what's going on with Haruka-san too. I can't believe she's just harmlessly attending their meeting. Yeah, there's no way. I'm going to be so mad and angry at this. I'm sorry.
I can already predict the future. I will be so mad. For the moment, I just headed towards the unused classroom. Occupied now. The normally silent classroom now was loud to the crowd voices. I peeked in from the back door and looked like they were in the middle of the debate. What? It's peaceful? How is this peaceful? What was I supposed to do? I didn't want to interrupt the meeting. Who? The cause of my small outburst was Haruka-san. She pulled me into one of the seats at the back of the classroom. What are you doing? Even so, this is still... Wait, was she preparing a lunch? To launch an offensive? Okay. Okay. I face palmed. I didn't know what to say. The prefect slammed her hand. Her hand? That's a guy. It's the black bro. Okay. It was a familiar looking scene. That is, it was one I'd seen those police shows where they post up all the usual suspects on the board to figure out the culprit. The explanation continued. The prefect proposed something like a regular patrol around the vending machine outside to a particular mischievous student. Since I had been there too at the time of the incident, that didn't sit well with me. Haruka-san, let's go out of here. Just as I was about to stop her, Haruka-san bolted up. There was a stare among the prefects. Haruka-san? Yes, and you are garbage. Futake-san standing up from the very front seat, turned and looked back to us. Haruka-san bought the stiffet. Haruka-san's confidence withered away, in stark contrast with the coldness Futake-san addressing with her. Haruka-san hit her palm on the desk twice. I don't want to listen to her. Takisan had a little mocking laugh.
あなたたちの評判をそれ以上落としてどうするの?普段からいろいろ騒がしいあなたたちなクルガヤさんたちも迷惑だと思ってるんじゃないかしら?
You are such a piece of shit. I swear.
ユイネはそんなこと言わない。第一、今は私の話でリキ君やユイネは関係ないと思っているのはあなたただけよ。最後さ、放課後よく一緒にいるらしいじゃない? あまり見せつけられても不純異性交友で指導しつい気になってもしらないわよ。あなたが誘ったのか、彼が乗ったのか知らないけど。The
eyes of all prefects in the room, some underclassmen, among them of course. Well, it was painful listening to this. I could hear them whispering.
Suggestive glances were exchanged. They were all looking at me with face mixed with contempt. Every fucking word is trash from your mouth. I cannot. I'm sorry, I said that many times, but I cannot. I don't know if I will survive this road. What the fuck? What a jerk, Haruka-san left for a throw back. With a jerk, sorry. Haruka-san suddenly threw over the desk. The loud noise echoed around the room. The classroom erupted. Just like them. Kicking at the desk, Haruka-san made a grab for the nearest prefect. Haruka-san, you can't stop it. Panicked, I held Haruka-san from behind. But she was violently flying around with her arms and legs. It was like a child throwing a tantrum. Net twinking the room was resounding with the cries and the yells. After it was over, we were put on cleaning duty. Haruka-san muttered a rag hungry limply on one hand. It's fine. Even though I said that my body was covering scratches and bruises, I hurt all over and my right cheek and spine were itching. I couldn't even remember how many punches and kicks I'd taken. Haruka-san repeated herself. I understand why you're upset with all those accusations. But freaking out like that is still wrong. Even so, it was Futaki-san that had pushed her to this. Even before I had to back her up, she had kept kindling Haruka-san flame. At the very least, Haruka-san cheerful troublemaker, a match had been shattered completely. Haruka-san merely hung her head, dejected, and didn't respond. Haruka-san, you're acting strange. Normally you'd make a comeback at that. Be sure Haruka-san had caused her fair share of disturbances. She was just goofy joker, who loved funny and strange stuff. If you compare that fight with the prefects, with her earlier stuff, the difference was just too striking. Something wasn't right, I thought.
Kishimono.
Huh?
Heiga Kishimono. Maku ikanai no. Dakara tanoshiku nai no. Itsumo nara tanoshii no.
You're talking about Futaki-san? Yeah, I can see that. I hate her too! We are together with this. Yeah! I hate her too! She's such a trash. Haruka-san spit the words out. Go away! Go away! I don't want you in the story! Get rid of her!
We're
done with all of it. I put a reassuring hand on Haruka-san's back. We are done, so may we return to the dorms?
Sorry,
I'm skipping her so fast, I just cannot stand her voice anymore. I cannot stand today her voice anymore. I'm sorry. As if remembering something at that point, Futaki-san quickened her lips a little. What are you trying to say? Wait, all of them? Started by sudden question, I started ticking them off my fingers. Library commit, culture commit, health commit, sports commit, cultural association. Other than that, the broadcast committee and the housing committee. I expected that actually. Like I said, like in the previous, like there is no possibility to have this kind of the committee. I mean, like the club with just one person, right? So it was just like Haruka doing. But still, she was just like repairing stuff around the school. So what's your fucking problem? Just treat it as the freaking hobby and a good work around the school, helping basically other students. Like, she repaired stuff that others use it. You're garbage. It was merged with disciplinary. Okay, so they merged together. So the disciplinary committee is like basically Haruka previous like co-workers, quote quote, from the her committee. Utake-san didn't look at Haruka-san as she spoke, only at me. No, I didn't. And what does it mean? Like, who cares? Like, what's your point? As though as afterthought, Futaki-san mentioned that it had made the club meeting even drier. Fuck you. You are going to fix it because you made that fucking mess. It's your fault. Piece of shit and garbage. You are fucking the worst. Sorry, no, not you guys. Her. She. Like, this abomination. Haruka-san left her face trembled visibly. Good! Good! That you find this offensive. Her words were kind on the surface, but her voice was stepping sarcasm. Futaki-san left. Haruka-san. But Haruka-san. Alright. Haruka-san hung her head, shoulders trembling. I saw no option but to do as she told me. At the entrance to the dorms, I ran into Futaki-san. Was she out on patrol? Well, she didn't have any of the other prefects with her. She was twirling a ballpoint pen around in her right hand. Is she waiting for someone? Nah, probably not. Probably for Haruka and want to do some bullshit again. I didn't look at her, simply continuing to walk my way. I don't care! Ricky, just follow your road. Just leave her. Just ignore. Just ignore. This is a thin air. Just don't exist. Ignore. Good, you find this cruel. Fuck you. I'm pretty sure you have done some cruel things too, just like bully. Yeah, exactly. Futaki-san shrugged. She slipped a ballpoint pen into her pocket with a sigh. You're pretty fucking... What was going on? I wasn't sensing any hostility in her words today. I don't care, her existence is hostility! You had something to talk with me about? Futaki-san, look at me. Her glance was the piercing as a bullet. Well, no, but I had no idea what she was suddenly talking about. Asking about. I don't think it works like that. Well, if that were true, I'd say the ratio of sadness in the world is a little unbalanced. Someone's unhappiness is another's happiness. Look at Komari. She's giving happiness to increase happiness. If you think of it that way, would you even stop wishing for the happiness of those dear to you? After that answer, Futaki-san felt silent. It was hard to tell what she was thinking from her expressionless face, but it seems like she was hesitating about something. That's what you wanted to ask me? My best what? Lexan gave me a small shrug. I don't see it as any fruitful. I hate you. I still hate you. Having said that, Futaki-san spun on her heel and headed off towards the female dorm. What was that? I had no idea what she was talking about. I shook my head. One day followed another without Haruka-san popping in the classroom before the first bell, and this is going to be the next episode. I'm so agitated. I need a break. I so need a break. I want to... I don't know when I will be recording next episode. This is so stressful. I'm like... I cannot read, I cannot talk, and I'm like trembling. That was the most stressful episode ever. I swear, this is like the most stressful episode. Is this the person that you mentioned like long time ago in one of my previous episodes in the comments? That there will be a character that I will hate more than Sasasagawa. And I'm not like hating Sasasagawa now, I just like dislike her because how bossy she is, I guess. But this is just a freaking garbage, I'm sorry. I cannot do outro. So yeah, thanks for like being with me on this episode, for listening to my screaming. And yeah, let me know what you think about Futaki. I will see you next one. Thanks, and for the Pocket Watch is going out.